portion of this video is brought to you by Incogni. Adding solar panels to your home is a bright idea, but according to one report from 2020, only about 6% of installed residential solar systems include battery storage. That's a bit of a power outage in a world of renewable energy. But with a home battery, you'll be able to store energy like a squirrel stores nuts for the winter. Not to mention, you'll be the coolest kid on the block with your virtual power plant system. So if you want to be the sunshine in your neighborhood, you should consider a home battery. But which one? Let's take a look at the top 5 battery options on the market and a couple of bonus alternatives to keep an eye on, even for renters. I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. I hope I don't sound like a broken record when I bring this up, but I'm building a new energy-efficient home with the goal of achieving net zero energy, meaning I'm producing as much electricity over the course of a year as I'm using. Now, a key component to that is energy storage. And as I've been planning out my new house, I've been compiling what I think are the top 5 home battery options on the market, with a couple of bonus callouts at the end. Without energy storage, I'd be flooding the grid with my excess solar production in the middle of the day. Now, that does get used by my neighbors and community, but it's not when the energy is needed most, like in the evening and overnight. With a battery system, more of the energy that I generate stays within my home, and it also offers self-sufficiency in case of a grid outage, which is not uncommon during New England winters. And my battery can participate in the Connected Solutions virtual power plant system here in my area. That helps the utility with electricity peak shaving during summer high demand events. The bottom line, I want my system to not only benefit my own home, but to also participate in helping with the resilience of the local grid and my community. Two big questions usually come up around home batteries though. What does it cost? And how long will it last? Another way to rephrase that would be, how good is it? So let's run through my top 5 list. Now, these are not in any particular order, so do not read into the order as like this one wins over that one. Okay, so the first one is kind of the obvious one. It's one of the most popular options out there right now, and that's the Tesla Powerwall. The newer Tesla Powerwall Plus has some impressive specs. It's an NMC battery chemistry, which is AC connected and has 13.5 kilowatt hours of usable storage capacity. It has one of the best power outputs that you can get with 7 kilowatts continuous power and 10 kilowatts peak. Now, a good example of why that's important, if you're running a 1000 watt microwave, that's 1 kilowatt that you're using as it's running. The higher the kilowatt capacity, the more things that you can run at once. Kilowatt hour is kilowatts over time. So that 1 kilowatt microwave could run for 13 and a half hours from a 13 and a half kilowatt hour battery, which would give you a very rubbery piece of chicken. Now, the Powerwall comes with a 10 year 70% capacity retention warranty. It's obviously going to continue working well beyond that, but that gives you a general sense for longevity as we compare these batteries. As for cost, all of these are pricey, but it costs $12,850 before installation, and with installation, that rough price comes in around $16,850 for the first one. It's cheaper per battery for the additional batteries that you add. And to get an apples-to-apples comparison with the other batteries, I've divided the total installed cost by the usable kilowatt-hour storage, which means that the Powerwall Plus comes in at around $1,248 per kilowatt hour. And these prices are going to vary wildly depending on where you live, so take these with a grain of salt. Now, the next option is a newer competitor and one that's pretty comparable to the Powerwall for capabilities, but with one key distinction. It's using a lithium iron phosphate or LFP battery chemistry, which has some advantages. LFP batteries are better than NMC batteries in terms of safety, lifespan, and tolerance for extreme temperatures. LFP batteries are more stable, have longer lifespan of up to 20 years, and are better suited for use in harsh environments. On the other hand, NMC batteries have higher energy density and are better suited for high power applications with limited space. That's why they're used in EVs. Now, the choice between the two depends on the specific needs for the application, but for home use, LFP is an excellent choice. Franklin's home battery system is AC connected and can store 13.6 kilowatt hours per battery module. It has 5 kilowatts continuous power with a peak of 10 kilowatts for 10 seconds, which makes it somewhat comparable to the Powerwall. Much like a Powerwall, there's an extra box called an A-gate that is like the brain of the system and can manage up to 15 linked batteries. That means a maximum of 204 kilowatt hours per A-gate setup, which is complete overkill for the average house. Now, another benefit in favor of Franklin is the support for AC backup generators, so you can layer in a backup to your backup for areas that can sometimes have outages that last for days. And having a generator plugged into a battery means not having to run the generator constantly, which reduces your fuel needs. Now, as for cost, you'd be looking at around $17,500 with installation, which does put this on the more expensive side of things, but that works out to about $1,287 per kilowatt hour for the first battery. And just like with the Powerwall, each additional battery that you add is cheaper than the first. And here's a benefit of the LFP battery chemistry. The warranty is a 12-year 70% capacity with an aggregate throughput of 43 megawatt hours. Before I get to the next top battery, I'd like to thank Incogni for sponsoring this portion of today's video. Now, I've mentioned this before, but I signed up for a newsletter from a small online retailer, and after I did, I saw a major increase in the number of promotional emails I was receiving from companies I've never heard of. And that's because they sold my information to a data broker. I've also had my information leaked through data breaches at companies like Target, Sony, and others numerous times. I'm sure you've experienced it too. In fact, I keep getting updates about new ones. Incogni can help you with this. We have the right to request that data brokers delete our information, but it takes a lot of time and effort. I signed up for Incogni, gave them the legal right to work on my behalf, and then just sat back and relaxed. You'll see updates in your account for which data brokers they've sent legal requests to and which ones have complied. It couldn't be easier. I've been letting Incogni stay on top of this for me for quite a while now, and I'm very happy with the results. I've noticed a difference. If you want to take back some of the control around who has access to your personal information, give Incogni a try. The first 100 people to use the code UNDECIDED at the link below will get 60% off Incogni. Thanks to Incogni and to all of you for supporting the channel. Now back to the third battery. SolarEdge is one of the biggest players in the home solar market. Their home battery is an NMC chemistry that's DC connected. It's meant to be tightly integrated with their SolarEdge string inverter solar panel setups, so the DC electricity that your panels generate flows straight down into the battery without any major conversion losses. That's really the biggest sales pitch of going all in on the SolarEdge system or any string inverter solar panel setup into a DC connected battery. Now, if you're pumping 5 kilowatts of solar generated electricity into the battery, 5 kilowatts is going in versus something like 4.7 kilowatts for a system that's converting from DC to AC and then back to DC. Now, one battery gives you about 9.7 kilowatt hours of usable storage, 5 kilowatts of continuous output, and 7.5 kilowatts peak. You can stack up to 3 of these per inverter for a total of 29.1 kilowatt hours of storage. The warranty falls right in line with the others at 10 years, 70% capacity retention. And for costs, you're looking at around $13,000 installed, so that would be roughly $1,340 per kilowatt hour for the first battery. But again, one big benefit here is the power capacity from the NMC chemistry, and you have the ability to integrate a fuel generator for additional backup protection. LG is another very popular option in the home battery market. Their newest offering is the ESS Home 8, which is an LFP battery chemistry and can be AC or DC connected. Total usable capacity is about 14.4 kilowatt hours with 7.5 kilowatts continuous and peak output. Just like the others, the more batteries that you add, the more usable storage and higher power output. You can max this out at 4 units for 57.6 kilowatt hours of storage. For the warranty, it's just like Tesla at 10 years, 70% capacity. Now, I couldn't find any costs which included installation, but the base cost is $11,200. If we ballpark the installation cost at around what a Powerwall costs, then we'd have to add about $4,000 to the price, which makes it roughly $15,200 installed. That's about $1,055 per kilowatt hour if that estimate does hold true. This is where the biggest player in the solar panel industry comes in, and that's Enphase with their Enphase IQ battery system. Enphase is known for their solar panel microinverter setup, which is the complete opposite approach of SolarEdge's string inverter and keeping things DC as long as possible. I won't get into all the details here, but there are different advantages to both paths. And one of the big ones for microinverters is redundancy, since there's no single central inverter to go down. The interesting thing here about their battery is that it uses 12 of the same exact microinverters that are placed behind each solar panel on your roof. That means the battery itself benefits from inverter redundancy as well. The Enphase IQ 10 battery is an AC connected LFP battery with 10.1 kilowatt hours of usable storage capacity and 3.84 kilowatts continuous power with 5.7 kilowatts peak. Now, as with all the AC connected batteries, the more modules you add, the numbers all go up. Similar to the LFP batteries, you're trading off the high continuous power output for longer cycle life and resilience, which is reflected in the warranty. Each battery comes with a 10-year warranty or 4,000 cycles, but you can purchase an extension for $1,000 per battery that increases the warranty to 15 years or 6,000 cycles. All in, you're looking at about $12,000 installed, which means about $1,188 per kilowatt hour for the first battery. And just like SolarEdge and most of the others, with the exception of Tesla Powerwall, you can connect a fuel generator backup. So like I said, these are my top 5 whole home options on the market right now, but there are 2 bonus items I want to call out. The first one is for renters or people who just don't want to bother installing an entire whole home system. There are options starting to spring up for renters like the Blip One, which gives you about 2.2 kilowatt hours of storage that can help you shift your energy costs if you have time of use rates. It's still coming to the market and was delayed a little bit, but the first batch hasn't been delivered yet, so we'll still need some time to see how that product shakes out. There are a lot of other options from companies like EcoFlow, who has sponsored previous videos here just for full disclosure, Bluetti and others that make large portable battery packs that can give you 3 kilowatt hours or more of storage. You can even plug solar into them directly to recharge during a blackout. Best part is that you can take it with you when you move to a new place. The last bonus item I want to call out is that there's some exciting options coming to the market that will last decades and should end up being price competitive with what's already here. It's still a little ways out, so I wouldn't recommend waiting for it yet, but the company Forever Energy is bringing a residential flow battery to the market. If it turns out to be as promised, it should cost about the same as a single Tesla Powerwall, but provide 3 times the storage and last for 30 years or more. Now, a single unit would provide about 10 kilowatts of power with 40 kilowatt hours of storage. You'd only need one small refrigerator-sized unit connected to your house, and you'd be all set. Now, I'm keeping my eye on that company because if it pans out, that's going to be a killer option for homes. So what do you think? Do you want any of these options for your home? Do you have any that you'd add to the list? Jump in the comments and let me know. I'm going with the Enphase system for my new home, but I'll be getting into all the details as to why in another video. And be sure to check out my follow-up podcast, Still to be Determined. We'll be discussing some of your feedback. And if you like this video, be sure to check out one of the ones over here. And thanks to all my patrons who get ad-free versions of every video for your continued support. And thanks to all of you for watching and commenting. I'll see you in the next one.